Hello and welcome to another video. In today's video, I'm actually answering a question that was written in on my YouTube channel from DebHunter9404. She says, "Hello, I use several lines to split payroll on a biweekly basis. It's the same split lines each time. Is there a way to save the categories so I do not have to enter them every time?" All right, Deb, we're gonna get into this in this video. Let's jump right in. Deb, thank you so much for writing in that question. Now, as I mentioned, there are a few ways that I would actually manage this. So, especially if the amount of each transaction is the same, here's my suggestion. I'm using a sample company. This is the QuickBooks online test drive version. And you know, I have the link for that in the description box below. And also, just so you know, I have a weekly newsletter that goes out and it tells you of each new YouTube video. So make sure you are subscribed to my newsletter and you'll get fresh content there as well. I'm also sending out some like PDFs each month that could be helpful and useful for you as you go through your financial journey, as you are a small business owner. So I touch all of those topics. But anyways, I wanted to make sure you know that this link for the test drive version is in the description box, as well as my newsletter link in the description box below. So the first way that comes to mind, actually, because I think you commented on the how to split a transaction video. I will also link that in the description box below. And I showed you in that video that, let's just say it's this transaction here. There's a way that you can split each transaction as it's coming through on the banking screen. And so this is one way that you can manage those types of things. You would, of course, add lines according to whatever you need in terms of which categories to use. If you have classes and locations, I believe that would populate under each of these split transactions. So if you split your transaction through the banking screen like this, and you also have class and location, that would show up as columns here as well. So that's one way that you can manage it. Pretty straightforward, pretty easy. Now, another way that I would suggest managing this is through a journal entry. So make sure you do the plus new sign and then you come all over to on the right side to journal entry. And so let's say this journal entry was for, you know, the end of last month. I don't think there's like a wage account here. I thought there was, but we could use, well, actually, let's see if we can just add it. Gross wages. Okay. So then you would add in your, where is it? There we go. I believe they have payroll expenses. Okay. Compensation, salaries and wages. Okay, so let's just call it salaries and wages. Oops. Oh my gosh, why am I adding it to? Okay, save and close. So then you would just, you know, code it however you need to code it. I'm just kind of throwing in an amount there. Obviously, I don't think small businesses are paying $50,000 in salaries, but let's say it was for multiple people, then you would have multiple lines down here. Now on the actual screen in your QuickBooks Online version, you'll be able to see the class and the location as columns here. So that's why I'm not populating it right now, because I just don't have that option under the test drive version. So you can also say like, okay, let's say it's for Cynthia. So then you can also add her as an employee in your QuickBooks Online. So of course you want to say Cynthia, I don't know, let's call her Cynthia Bookkeeper. How original, huh? Let's see here. And then contact type is employee. So then you would just do that for all of your employees. And of course, let's say it's through the checking and then it's 50,000. So then save and close. And the reason why I wanted to walk you through that is because here's what you would do if you're actually kind of coming in there each month and allocating the salaries. So you would come back to the plus new sign all the way to the other column journal entry. You would go back to that journal entry that you just entered. So go back to the January journal entry. Everything is already here. All you have to do is copy this. And then it automatically copies. You can say this is for, you know, February 29th. And then everything's the same. Save and close. So now I've just done two journal entries for January and February that has all of the same categories, so the same amounts. Let's say if it was different amounts, then you would just change the amount in each of the journal entries. And then when it populates on your banking feed, then, you know, you would just match it, like similar to what it looks like with this deposit here. You would just click on match and you're good to go. So that is probably my favorite way to manage that, because I feel like with payroll and salaries and wages, it's not all the same amount each time because there's different variations. Taxes might be different. The number of days might be different. The number of hours might be different. There could be so many variations to your payroll journal entry that I feel like the best way to manage that is through a journal entry. The last way I wanted to mention was through the recurring transactions. So you can actually create, like, this sample account has two recurring transactions already listed here. And you can see here that it's for a telephone bill, it's scheduled every month, and the amount and the next due date. And so you can actually do something similar to that. It's going to look like, so you would, you know, select journal entry here, and then it's going to look like a journal entry template that we already went over. So you would just call it whatever you need to call it. So we can say salaries and wages here. So then we all know, okay, this is for the salaries and wages journal entry. Create, you can say 7 days in advance. In my kind of opinion, I feel like doing it a week ahead of time is going to be really helpful, just so you can see it when it comes through. Monthly, and then I would say like on the last day of the month or whenever your payroll schedule is, then that's when you want it to go. Start date, then you would just enter the start date. Let's say February 1st. I'm sorry, let's say March 1st. We're in February. Okay, and then it's the same thing here. So you would select salaries and wages. Yeah, 50,000. Okay, so it'd be 50,000 in the debit section, and then you could just say salaries and wages for the month or whatever you want to call the description. Let's just say Cynthia Bookkeeper again, and then of course you would list whoever else is getting paid for that month as well, and then the checking account, and voila, we have this recurring template ready to go, and it's going to populate 7 days before March 1st. You can always go in there and edit the journal entry ahead of it actually coming through your bank feed. So that is another way that you can do it. So then save template, and then there it is, salaries and wages. So those are three different ways that you can manage the splitting of a recurring transaction. And tell me in the comments, was this helpful? Do you think that you'll do the journal entry, the recurring transaction, splitting it through the bank feed? Let me know in the comments below. I love to hear from you. And I'm going to be doing some more videos in terms of answering your questions. So I would love to hear your questions. If you have any other questions, feel free to put them in the comments below. You can also follow me on Instagram and message me over there. I'm pretty active. And I'll put my Instagram handle here. And that's all I have for you guys today. I hope you have a beautiful afternoon, and I will see you guys in the next video.